to see isn't a restoration. It's a resurrection. What I have here on the table beside me are two Masters of the Universe vehicles that my brother grew up with when we were kids. I have the Attack Track and the Dragon Walker. In the Masters of the Universe line, the battery-powered vehicles were sort of the Ministry of Funny Walks. They all had very unconventional methods of travel through battery-operated mechanisms. What's frustrating about Masters of the Universe toys is that they have no screws to get into them to disassemble them. They're actually sonic welded or clipped together. And it kind of brought up an interesting observation I hadn't considered before. Whereas Star Wars has the frustration of figures you cannot easily disassemble and fix if they're broken, but vehicles that you can because they have screw systems in them and you can take them apart, as you've seen on our previous videos, G.I. Joe is in reverse. With G.I. Joe, you can take apart the action figures, but you can't take apart the vehicles. Well, with He-Man, you can't take apart anything. The figures and the vehicles are all frustrating to restore and maintain. So in this case, what I had were two vehicles that I'd grown up with that were my brother's, but both of their battery-operated mechanisms had failed. And so what I'm going to do is show you how I got those working again, because you can't actually disassemble them to get to any of the motors. So let's get started.
We should be almost there. Hold it, Attack Track.
Affirmative. Full stop.
Wow.
We'll start with the Attack Track. As you can see, this one's in pretty good shape for one that was played with from a kid who was 3 years old forward. It still has 3 out of the 4 rubber bands on it, and I'll attempt to find one of those later. But again, this isn't a restoration. We're just trying to get the mechanisms to run again. It had some very unique tread movement. It would pull itself along, and then the tread would flip over, and then the gear would pull it along again on all four. What we want to do is get it going again, but as you can see, there are no screws holding this together. It's all clipped or welded somehow. It's just one big hunk of plastic, which is cool, I guess, if you like a clean look, but it's not good for longevity. Battery compartments in the bottom. First thing we'll do is open this up and make sure that the contacts are clean. First step in making sure contacts are clean, as we've discussed in other videos, is try a pencil eraser. Try using that on there first because it doesn't mar anything and it can get your contacts clean. These look pretty good. I have a feeling what happened is this engine has seized. So now that we've got that done, check your battery configuration. Positive on this side, negative on this side. Since we're testing, we don't need to necessarily close it up. Now, I know for a fact that this thing hasn't been working. How do you get the motor going again? Well, the best thing you can do is pop off one of the treads. Just pull gently and it should come off. All right, treads off. The Attack Track was rear wheel drive. I don't know how many horsepower it had, but it was rear wheel drive, classic muscle car design. And what you want to do is flip the engine on and then turn the engine in the proper direction, which is clockwise. If you're on the back of the vehicle facing forward, you want to spin that gear. Let's see. You want to spin it counterclockwise. So spin it counterclockwise. If you spin it clockwise, you'll hear it clack. Prime it a little bit. Get it going. And then let's see what happens. There we go. So that's how you get access to that engine to keep that moving. All right, let's move on to the Dragon Walker. The Dragon Walker was a really innovative vehicle design. The idea was that this seat would move along this track, and then when it got to the end of the track, there was a spinning gear. And what would happen is that the mechanism would turn the track, and then it would move forward and it would turn the track again. It wasn't very precise. A lot of times it ended up just going in a large erratic circle, but it was kind of cool to watch and it was a really innovative design. So what we need to do is figure out why this guy isn't working. The batteries and the mechanism are all in the Dragon head. You can just take this and shove it over here. So if you flip it over, you'll notice that underneath you have a battery cover. It says use a coin. That's kid friendly. Adults can use a flathead screwdriver. And we want to pop this off. Might take you a few tries. All right, so now we're going to open this up. I don't know if you can see this, but right here there's the small gear system that moves the dragon head along the track. I'm going to warn you right now, this gear does not move when you try and move it. It's not like the attack track where you can just spin it or one of those Star Wars motors. This thing is on a locked system, so don't attempt to pry it. You could break one of the teeth. Now, inside are the battery connectors. You have two more on the bottom of the cover, but these battery connectors inside are what you really need to get to. You can clean this very easily because you can get to these. Again, start with a pencil eraser and try and clean those off if they look dirty. What I discovered as I troubleshot this whole thing, because there are no screws on any of this to get into it, and you wouldn't want to anyway because you have stickers that go over the seam lines, so you gotta find a more clever way to do it. What I couldn't figure out when I was working on mine is the battery connectors were clean, I had good batteries, everything seemed to be in order, and it wasn't working. What I discovered was that these connectors inside can actually become dislodged by sliding upward from their mount. So if you feel inside with a pencil eraser, it's the best way to do it because the pencil eraser creates friction, so you can get some traction on it and move it around. If it moves under the pencil eraser, if the whole connector moves up or down, that means it's come dislodged from the motor. So what you really want to do is get your pencil high up on the top of the connector and pull it back down, and you'll feel it snap back in. The moment I did that, we were ready to go. So then you put your positive on the left, negative on the right, put this funky cover back on. Okay, got it on our track. Where is the switch? As you can see, it doesn't really go in a straight line, so you gotta watch it. As you can see, Masters of the Universe vehicles are quirky because you can't access the internal mechanisms, so when it comes to repairing them, you have to look for some unique workarounds. Most of the time, you need to look for a disconnected battery connector, or you need to look for a place where you can physically get to the motor from the outside and spin it. I hope this has been helpful for you guys, and we'll see you on the next restoration. Which is an amazing vehicle. It looked nothing like it did in the show. It was just an absolute disaster in the show. It was a talking automaton that carried Prince Adam to and fro Eternia. What? Of course I'm the same person.